Quality heavy push here from Jung Ji-hee on the receive. Good angle here from Tianyue, quick to send that back.
Nice quick backhand cross court from Tianyue. Just closing the face of her bat and getting the win across court.
One, two.
And a deep push here for a surprise.
Three, one. Nice deep return of serve from Tianyue. Both the returns were deep, actually. The first one was to the backhand side of Ji-hee. The previous one to the extreme forehand. So she's already starting mixing up the service returns.
Left, 3-1.
Oh, perfect positioning here. Jung Ji-hee behind the table plays it right back into the elbow of Feng Tianyue.
Feng wasn't ready for that shot, I think. She just reached for her forehand side, thought she had the winner, and then was surprised when the ball came back to her body.
I'm very entertained by the musical choice for the in-and-outs. It's just funny because it's such a lyrical song, you know. You want to hear it the whole way through, only getting a few second snippets. Oh man, good times. Seems like a sketch, like a comedy sketch, really. 3 points apiece right now. Good power and placement. Jung Ji-hee going forehand to backhand with Feng Tianyue. That should be, well, favoring Jung Ji-hee, at least in terms of power.
Yeah, the cross court shots from Tianyue are going to Ji-hee's forehand side. Remember, she is a left-handed player.
Good move into the table. Now, Varsha, can you tell us a little bit about some of the advantages of being left-handed in table tennis?
I don't think there is an advantage. It's just that the right-handed players sometimes are not used to playing left-handed.
That sounds
players.
Like a good advantage,
yeah,
to me.
While the left-handed players get all the practice against the normal right-handed players.
Exactly.
There are much fewer left-handed players around, just as there are in any other game.
That surprise factor, sort of the rarity of playing against one. A lot of people have trouble against left-handed players. Oh man, good times.
This never used to happen before, you know.
It's just
music in between points.
I like it. It's just a question of the choice of songs. Feng Tianyue playing it down the line from behind the table. This is some serious pressure here. Spin comes in short strokes. You can see how high the racket is from Feng Tianyue between shots, and it all pays off. Watch where she keeps it.
Two balls played from the extreme forehand, and then the third one was down the line for the outright winner. A nice two-point buffer, and she's got two serves to come.
Nice kick serve here, fast, accelerating off the second bounce. Feng Tianyue with a good score line here to make the home crowd happy. But we've seen bigger leads recovered, or deficits. Well played serve again inside the table, that half long serve where you can't tell if you should step in and play it off the bounce or wait for it to come off the table.
Six, 6-9.
This serve just felt like such a handcuffing serve. Inside the table, little bit of topspin right near the baseline. Shovel serve, tough to read. Both players using their serves very effectively out here. Stroke is so quick, it's her forehand too.
Yeah, this was a nice return of serve from Tianwei. Just looking, seeing that the ball was slightly long from the table and straight away she played the attacking shots.
So 4 game points now to the Singaporean Feng Tianwei. Oh, right at the back of the table.
Oh, for sure. I think Feng Tianwei has played so many years of table tennis. She was ranked number 2 at one point, which was in 2011. So those were the times she must have played Jihee a few times and had the wins.
Yeah, you can see the speed there, the angle that Feng Tianwei plays. A left-handed player likes to do that to a righty, but Feng Tianwei is very clever. Ooh, and an omiyage. That's Japanese for gift to Feng Tianwei. Thank you for having me here in Singapore. It's just amazing how she's able to sort of maneuver around the table and find room for that full forehand stroke despite the obstacle of the table being there.
The ball just catching the net and going a little long. She was trying to play the backhand flick there, but the previous serve was so good. She set up the short return and played the third ball attack. She's into a 3-1 lead.
Changing it up a bit on the serve, just to change up the geometry out here. And it causes some problems. That's a very well-placed serve. And there's less room to sort of play it out to that forehand from the middle. So Jun Jihee putting a bit more pressure on herself, but delivering the serve and giving that pressure back to Feng Tianwei. Ooh, headshot. Not personal, obviously, but it'll be cool to see in replay, won't it?
Yeah, we don't see this too often.
What did you say? Get down. One more time. Nobody talks to me like that. Ah. Apologies there from Jun Jihee. Obviously unintentional. Edge of the racket. Nice placement. Deep serve into that elbow just off the hip there. So Jun Jihee couldn't come in over the table. Has to backpedal and try to take the shot from a little behind the table.
Nice return to the extreme forehand of Tianwei, who tried to play the forehand topspin. Just couldn't pull it off. She's still got a nice buffer though, 3-5.
Ooh. 3-6.
You don't see that very often. I think she just stopped. She wanted to play the backhand topspin and just kind of decelerated.
Ah, kick serve. Kicks up and out into the edge of the racket. It's funny, we did a live interview with Feng Tianwei for WTT and some local players. And I was just thinking, 35? I can't believe it. And she plays such a fast physical game, too. She's not using long pips. Really an active player. So 13 years straight in the world top 13. The majority of that time she's been in the top 10, Feng Tianwei, still one of the greatest threats to Chinese opponents. And her timing, catching the ball on the uprise, she just keeps that racket so high and is very comfortable with the fast pace of play.
The forehand flick followed by the very quick, almost on the half volley shot, the forehand topspin.
Very active. active play on the other side, though. Jung Ji-hee moving around to that wide forehand. Quick recovery. Very fluid game. Funny, yeah. Jung Ji-hee has risen a lot in the last few years. I think it might have been here in Singapore, actually, that she was able to beat the world number one, Chung Meng.
8-6.
The winner of this match will actually play Chung Meng in the quarterfinals, so we'll have to wait and watch who gets there.
We shall see. Right now, Feng Tianwei setting herself up to be in a much better position. These best of five games go quickly.
10-7.
Now that's tough. Perfect placement right into the body. The elbow there. Feng Tianwei with not a lot of place to go.
Yeah, she was so far forward trying to play this forehand topspin that she didn't expect the ball to come back. Ji-hee did very well there to return the first shot.
8-9. A bit of fire here, some vocalization. Feng Tianwei with a massive point after a big lead here. And this is the game that she's really going to want to take. Feng Tianwei moving in. You can see the shoes. Vibrant shoes, just lighting up the court. She's already cashed in her timeout. Oh, finds the deep forehand corner, and it cannot be touched on the other side.
Two consecutive balls played by Tianwei cross court onto Ji-hee's extreme forehand, and she hasn't even touched either of them.
This is what that middle is all about. As soon as she gets Jung Ji-hee to commit to turning to play the forehand from the middle, she's exposed on the wide forehand side. Two game points now for Feng Tianwei. And the touch shot does it. 2-0 lead. And then came to Singapore and has been on fire ever since.
Right.
So it's been incredible. I mean, she led Singapore to world champions over China in 2010.
Yes.
Beating Liu Shiwen and Ding Ning. So, I mean, this is just the difference, right? I mean, both of these players born and raised in China and realized they might not be able to live their dreams if the competition was too strong.
Yeah.
And now Feng Tianwei, a mega superstar, a world champion, multiple time Olympian. I mean, she's just really a superstar of the sport. Had she stayed in China, she might have been a bench warmer and become a coach, or who knows, you know?
Yeah, for sure.
One, two.
Life is filled with so many choices. And I think table tennis is analogous for life because the players have to make choices very quickly out here, and it could be serve long, serve short, where to push, when to open. But over the table here on the forehand side, the choice for that backhand receive sets Feng Tianwei up with a 2-point lead here. And the serve's back on her side. Just dancing around the court, painting the corners of the table, testing the footwork. Open rally, counter topspin, short strokes, inside out forehands, and Jung Ji-hee bending balls both ways, dismissive punching backhand. Oh, the devastation of Feng Tianwei's feeling, timing, and decision making. 35 years old, please, I can't wait to see her when she's 40.
And she's taken a 4-1 lead in the third.
2-4.
You know, when we were looking through the head-to-head, the fact that both of the wins for Jung Ji-hee were at the same tournament makes you wonder, what if there was an injury? What if there was some emotional lapse? But I mean, 10 victories on the other side and the last two for Feng Tianwei. She's showing her dominance out here now. But a good backhand here, quality opening from Ji-hee.
She hasn't played this shot too often in the match so far. But that was a nice time for her to play it at 2-4 down. A good backhand topspin, which Tianwei could not control the return.
Left. 3-6. Three,
so for those of you newer to table tennis, a let serve hits the net and then comes down where it's supposed to. Perfect placement, jamming up Feng Tianwei in that backhand corner right on the elbow.
Good recovery from Jihee here. In spite of the backhand cross-court played by Feng Tianwei, she held her ground and played another forehand topspin.
Funny, I was thinking about Jun Jihee and basically the muscle development. In the last several years, I feel like she's gotten fitter and stronger and faster. Just a leaner sort of faster play. And if you follow her on Instagram, you can see the workout she does, what she goes through to stay flexible.
Great returns from Tianwei. Again, she recovered quickly after playing the forehand half smash. Look at her movement going forward, taking a step back, taking another step back. But luckily for her, she won this point even from away from the table.
Good angle here. Jihee going outside the exit angle, just out of reach. It's funny, Feng Tianwei is so well practiced. She doesn't miss much at all. I've called her the wall before. You can hit it around her, but it's tough to hit it through her. Outstanding pace in this rally. A lot of work for 1 point.
Yeah, Jihee has picked up her game. I think she's playing with a lot more pace. After being love two down, she realizes that she has to take the attack to Tianwei. Staying close to the table and playing beautiful counter-attacking shots.
So out of the second towel break, dead even now. Jihee, it's Jun Jihee with her back against the ropes. She must win every game in this match from now on to take the match.
Stop. Please, no flashlights.
Ah, thank you, umpire. Feng Tianwei saying, crack on the ball. I'd like a new one, please. Funny, at the World Championships last week, there was flash patrol everywhere. The fans were just, flash, your flash is on. Sort of exciting and cool.
Oh, a beautiful forehand flick from Jihee, but what a return from Tianwei, taking off her body.
Yeah, this is the risk. I mean, it is, as you mentioned, an outstanding receive. One more time. Interesting. Tough to recover from that over the table play when it comes back that fast. Good setup here on the serve. Follows it right up, earns herself a good ball to attack. The speed out here is just unbelievable. Yeah. I think to myself of the rhythm that they have right off the stomp on the serve, that it's just, if you focus on one player throughout a rally, yes, you're gonna miss the big picture, but it'll be a new experience to realize how fast they have to recover.
Oh yes, that was a great shot from Jihee. Tianwei was expecting the ball to be played to the center of the table. But when it came to her extreme forehand, that's where she was caught out.
So now 3 game points for the player who must win this game to survive.
Length, 7-10.
Jun Jihee. Beautiful flick. Feng Tianwei fights to hang on at the third towel break. Still 2 game points left for Jun Jihee to send this into a fourth.
A nice serve from Tianwei, getting the short return, but then doing well this time to play the down-the-line shot. couple of times she's played the ball cross court, and the balls come back to her very quickly.
The counter does it, the backhand, allowing the first quality attack to come in and sending it back quickly. Quite thin, doing very well in table tennis. Now this will be big for Feng Tianwei. She does not want this to come down to a decider. Mentally, it's tough when you're up 2-0 and the opponent has that much momentum.
Yeah, for sure.
It's funny, we saw Feng Tianwei move her leg out of the way to create room for that forehand, just like we saw Lee Song Su do earlier today.
2-0.
Time that Feng Tianwei has missed her forehand flick.
She's really playing that shot very well. She's getting the short return on her serve, and she has to move forward. But this time, she was ready to play the cross-court backhand after that.
And a parallel backhand here as well. What a well-prepared player, Feng Tianwei.
Yeah, she didn't move to play the forehand topspin. Instead, she stayed her ground and played the down-the-line shot.
New ball, please. At the World Championships, players were allowed to choose 15 balls each to select them, test them, make sure they were to their liking. Wouldn't be surprised if it's something similar here. Acceleration from behind the table and right into the middle of the table.
A lot of power behind that shot from Tianwei. First taken from the side of the table and then from the extreme forehand. Just too much spin for Jihee to handle. Was played very deep as well on the table.
Not even for
2.
The backhand topspin attempt from Tianwei just mishits the ball. She's still got a good lead, though, at 5-2 and one serve to come. Tianwei has upped her intensity. Again, that was a powerful forehand topspin play to the center of the table.
Let 2-6.
Jihee is trying very hard to play the attacking shot first, but she really needs to catch up. She's just playing into Tianwei's hand.
2-7.
Such a confident opening attack here. Feng Tianwei with full extension on this forearm. An outstanding swing. Or forehand, I should say, right down the middle of the table. Sets her up with a 6-point lead, just 3 points away from moving on to the quarterfinals of the women's singles event here. Again, $600,000 on the line to give away.
A commanding lead now in the fourth game. She's shown a lot of variation in the forehand topspin. It's not coming at the same pace that Jihee would like. She's really mixing up the balls.
Three,
what's what's the greatest comeback you've seen in your lifetime?
I don't know.
Just off memory, if you think of a greater one later, I won't hold you to it.
Actually, it was round of 32 match in the World Championships. Tian Wei was 8-6 up in the final game against the Korean So Hyo-won, and she lost 5 points in a row. That was so disappointing for her.
Nine,
but that's only 5 points. This is coming back from only 5 points down.
It's funny, there was a player, I want to say Wang Jianjun from China against Ma Lin, I want to say 2003, give or take, was down, I think, 3-10. Wow. He was up 10-3, and Ma Lin came back to win the national championship. Wow. Oh, backhand on that line. Feng Tianwei fighting, and she earns herself 5 match points. Look at the pressure here. Backhand to backhand, turns for a forehand, another forehand to cover the middle, and still pins it on that line. Just very persistent with that placement. And Feng Tianwei takes care of business. 3-1 over Zheng Jihe. She moves on in front of a home crowd.